Yes, more Star Wars news. Great. And there's actually pretty good news. The final chapter of the Star Wars Jedi series is actually coming out. Now, I do want to say that this was already sort of mentioned, I think, in February. We sort of had a confirmation that the third game was happening, but it wasn't like... It's not EA saying these things. And now it's kind of like, okay, this is what's going to happen. Now it's pretty much confirmed the game is at some point coming out, which... It's actually quite a surprise, purely because Star Wars games don't always get trilogies. You know, we've had the old Battlefront 1 and 2, third was cancelled. We have the newest Battlefront 1 and 2, no news about the third one. We have Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2, third one being cancelled. Do I know any other ones right now? I don't think so. The only series that kind of like went on was the Jedi Knight series, but even that had different names. So yeah, so that's kind of the only story within games, I think, as far as I know, that, you know, just had a trilogy at least, or multiple games that was trying to portray a story. But yeah, so we're getting a third game. I'll have to be honest, before we get into this, I haven't been the biggest fan of the latest games and stories and everything that's been happening ever since Disney has acquired Star Wars. That's just my opinion. I'm not gonna bring it out in too much of a negative sense, but not the biggest fan. This game series, I've been thoroughly enjoying it. I did have a lot of problems trying to enjoy Jedi Survivor because no matter what graphical setting I would set in, I just couldn't properly play the game. And it definitely left me a sour taste. Now, I do have to say that they finally fixed it partially by getting rid of the Nuvo and the game actually performing way better. But I haven't been able to test that, so I actually don't know if that is completely true. But I hope it is, because I might have to replay it at some point. I did actually play Fallen Order again before Survivor came out, so as to get back used to the story. And I've just enjoyed the stories, and I've enjoyed the game, and I really like the gameplay they set up in these things. I'm not the biggest fan of the whole Souls-like gameplay that we've been having lately with any type of games. I'm kind of getting sick and tired of them. But I think for the third one, it's kind of fine to just finish it with the same type of gameplay. It's like they have the graphics down. They have the mechanics down. Just improve on those points and then release the game instead of changing everything. And people will maybe have a split decision whether they like it or not. It's better to just keep going with the things you're doing. You'll still have people that are going to dislike it because they want something different, that they don't want the same game over and over again, and they might even call it a Star Wars Jedi Survivor DLC or a Jedi Survivor 2. But I'm just saying, just improve on the things you already did, and I'm sure the game will come out amazing. At the end of the day, this is mostly about the story. When it comes to casual players, they will mostly care about the story, as long as the story has a very strong focal point. And if the performance is actually good, I hope they learn their fucking lesson. If the performance is well enough, then it might be a game of the year. But it depends on which year they come out and what other games they have to face. But anyways, article. I said the Respawn is developing the final chapter of its Star Wars Jedi story. Laura Meal, president of EA, mentioned the project during a presentation last Tuesday. We have delivered some of the highest quality and best-selling Star Wars games of all time with over 5 billion net bookings, she said. Could be because the prices are a little bit higher than, let's say, 20 years ago when Star Wars games were on their highs. The impressive track and the amount of microtransactions that certain games have had in the past. I'm not going to mention them. This impressive track record includes, of course, Star Wars Jedi games, where over 40 million Star Wars fans have connected with Cal Kestis and his arc of becoming a powerful Jedi. Respawn is working hard to bring the final chapter of this thrilling story to play. Give them a break, will you? Working hard sounds like you're trying to give them 12 hours a day. Stig Asmussen, directors, left Respawn last year and since formed a new studio. Before he left, he said he had hoped to... I feel like this is just a bit of extra text. I think this is mostly the... This is kind of the only sentence you want to read. Everything else is kind of just like, we had a pretty decent idea of time frame where we wanted Survivor to take place, what the stakes were going to be, what the tone of the game was going to be, what Carl was going to be up against, and how the crew was going to factor into that. And there's ideas of what we could do beyond that as well. This doesn't really tell me much about this whole final chapter thing. It's just a bit of extra. So, yeah. Okay. All in all, I say good news. It's not like the biggest news. It's kind of like a hard confirmation because we've already heard about this back in February. But yeah, now we just have to wait when it comes out. There's no time frame I could guess from. There's 4 years apart. Might be 2027. There you go. I guessed it. If I'm right, subscribe. Actually, don't. Subscribe now because otherwise I have to wait 2 years for you. 3 years! For you guys to join my channel. Don't do that. Come now, please. I have lots of content. Anyways, I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to thank you all for watching. It's been an absolute pleasure. I'll see you all in the next video. Take care and peace.